So divide it by 4 and by 4.
African photography project, and the way I see it is, I see it as a group of young guys doing what they do, and they have made up their mind to affect Africa in a way, in their own subtle way. They are they are determined to cause a change in whatever they do, and then they have also determined on their own to affect their lives, because what we see is what affects us. What we take in, what we see every day is what affects us. For example, when we were going from Lagos to Cameroon, and then we were passing through the sinking mud of Cameroon. I call it sinking mud because that was where our van sank for like 3 days before we pulled, 3 to 4 days before we pulled it out. You know, I see a group of young guys trying to tell the story of Africa.
It's been 2 days of non-stop traveling, so to speak, and we've stopped at this place because when we crossed the border almost into the Gabonese side, we were told that we couldn't cross because we had to fill a form, and that we couldn't fill that form yesterday evening when we got there by 5 past 5, and that we had to come this morning to fill the form. Initially, we were given the form to go and photocopy and fill ourselves, and when we tried to explain to the official that we don't have any place to photocopy at that time of the evening, we don't know any place around here, he took back the form and said we've just complicated things for ourselves. And the shocking thing is that you find people in these places who give no, who do not care about you, who do not care about where you're coming from, what possibly you could be doing in their space, and it's so amazing how wicked people could be.
Yeah. be atashwaju al sahara jayelena afzona oroni hadavna asenishunu udrakula maindina ki niseki kev al sahara jayelena al sahara jay al sahara jay Al Sahara Jai Abzona Ninna Sahara Jai Lena Abzona Ninna Ju Yok Tulna Darna kullu gata wal matra matisuble nazarena mal bir kullu yibiso napkoshunu wasane niseki ke al sahara jayele Al Sahara Jai, Al Sahara Jai, Elena, Al Sahara Jai, Abzona Ninna Sahara Jai, Elena, Abzona Ninna Ju Yok Tuna.
Pikinino labamta, suma cozinheira o tarbaja, suma costureira o pedela, suma bidera o tarbaja. Tarbaja, tarbaja, tarbaja. Oiê. Tarbaja pra nunca passar fome, pra livrar-nos de portas de guindo. No kaenda num nomo Mas deu sombra o sombra que fresco que vida o no levanta É mostrar noel o joja non jor se favor no levanta
Okay, we're in a Visu Brothers road trip 2012 and the fourth edition. And we've been traveling for almost 6 weeks now. from Lagos to Libreville. The intention was to go all the way to Lubumbashi in Congo, but we couldn't do that. So we had to stop at Libreville. And one of the reasons why we did that was because of the fact that we realized that there's a lot of issues and there's a lot of issues to deal with and to discuss and to talk about and to work with. I'm talking about transcending borders. So we decided that instead of going off to Congo, that we should concentrate in Cameroon, on Cameroon and Gabon. And one of the biggest challenges of the road trip so far are the roads, traveling from Nigeria, especially traveling from Nigeria to Cameroon. It's been very, very difficult. First of all, the first challenge was between Ekok and Manfe. Ekok is the border town between Nigeria and Cameroon, towards the south of both countries. And there's supposed to be a trans-African highway, you know, linking Nigeria to Cameroon from that end. But unfortunately, this highway is until today not non-existent. It doesn't exist, and it's been so since the independence of both countries. Since about more than 52 years now, there's not been any road built. It is only now that the Africa Union has awarded a contract to the Chinese, some Chinese company, and being funded by Africa Development Bank. But what I would like to say is that, first of all, let's begin by saying that it is completely not advisable to travel across Africa during rainy season. Don't do that. If you do it, you'll be faced with something like this.
Why not say you?
If you say you're talking for your mother, they say you're talking
about it.
Salam fi Darfur.